Hi friends, how are you all? Suppose if God is there in front of you and you are asked to ask for your wish, God is going to fulfill your wish and He is standing in front of you. Okay, then definitely will you feel happy for that? I hope so. You will be very happy if God is there in front of you and ask for your wish, okay, then definitely, okay, you will be asking for so many wishes, whichever you are dreaming for, isn't it? If same is the case with me, what will I ask to God? Naturally, being a new YouTuber, what I will ask? To get more subscribers, yes. Sometimes I feel like if Doraemon gadget is there with me. Okay, I'll ask Doraemon to have one gadget for me so that I'll get a lot many views to my YouTube videos as well as a lot many subscribers. Okay, more than 1 lakh subscribers, more than 10K subscribers. Okay, if it is the case like that, okay, that too within very short time. Okay. I feel sometimes like if I being Nobita, okay, always Nobita relies on Doraemon's gadgets only, okay, to do a small kind of work to a very big work, okay, Nobita always relies on Doraemon's gadgets only. So if one such kind of gadget is there with me, I will also first increase my subscriber count, increase my number of views and increase I will become famous. Okay, so every YouTuber, new YouTubers will keep thinking like that only. Okay, so this is your Lalita Peri ma'am, your science teacher, and basically I teach chemistry and I'm keeping on uploading study videos in YouTube. Okay, so I request all of you, those who are watching my videos for the first time, okay, let my wish be fulfilled as soon as possible so that I can increase my subscriber count, I can increase my views, okay, if I can able to reach you in a positive way. Okay, so I'm trying my best to reach you in a positive way without any Doraemon's gadget. Okay, I'm trying my best in whatever all the ways I can. I'm just exploring the different ways so that I can reach you all in a very positive way, that too in a very short span of time. Okay, so today we are going to learn about what we call oxidation numbers of carbon. Okay, only carbon. Carbon is going to exhibit oxidation numbers from -4 to +4. Again, ma'am is into the topic. Again, I thought she will be telling us about Doraemon's gadgets and all, something like that. But again, she entered into the topic and she'll continuously teach with the topic and nothing else. No entertainment for us. Okay, maybe you people all are thinking like that. Yes, teachers are there to teach you. Okay, sometimes teachers will be entertaining children also. Okay, not only teaching, we are entertaining you also. Okay, but I am a new YouTuber, I know that. But how to entertain you? I am saying no, I am exploring different ways and I'll definitely come up with new ways to entertain you also. Okay, so but for today, as we are bounded with studies are very much important. Of course, entertainment also is useful for us to get energized, I know that. Okay, but still, okay, we have to learn with our studies also, right? Okay, so oxidation number of carbon. Okay, we are going to learn about what? Oxidation number of carbon in different compounds. Oxidation number, it's not only oxidation, it is oxidation number. Okay, oxidation number of carbon in different compounds. Okay, so that is our topic for today. oxidation number of carbon in different compounds. So oxidation number of carbon can be from minus 4 to plus 4. In different compounds, it will exhibit different oxidation numbers. Okay, mostly from minus 4 to ON of carbon can be from minus 4 to plus 4. Okay, in some compounds, it may be negative values or it may be zero in some compounds. Okay, so like that, oxidation number of carbon in different compounds ranges from where to where? From minus 4 to plus 4. Okay, we'll see examples. Okay, examples. Right, dear children. Okay, so let us start with the oxidation number of carbon in CO. Okay, CO, carbon monoxide. First one is what? Carbon monoxide. Oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2 and carbon is x. So 1 into x plus 2, 1 into minus 2. Okay, 1 carbon, 1 oxygen. Okay, is equal to 0. So x minus 2 is equal to 0. So x equal to 2. So oxidation number of carbon in, carbon monoxide in CO is equal to what? Plus 2. Okay, if you go for the structure, structure of carbon monoxide, here C triple bond O. Okay, generally the structure of carbon monoxide is what? C triple bond O. Okay, actually it will have 4 valence electrons, so it will form a double bond with oxygen. Oxygen is having what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, oxygen will have a complete octet will be there. So oxygen acts as a donor here and it can contribute this pair of electrons, to carbon, so that it can form a coordinate covalent bond. But here this coordinate covalent bond is not considered here. Okay, wherever electronegativity element is acting as a donor, there more electronegative element. Here among carbon and oxygen, more electronegative element is what? Oxygen. And oxygen is acting as a donor here. Okay, so the coordinate covalent bond which is formed so by more electronegative element as donor is not considered as a single bond in case of coordinate covalent bond. Okay, otherwise generally coordinate covalent bond is treated as what? Single bond. Okay, or sigma bond. Okay, here we are not considering this. We are considering only the bond that is formed between carbon and oxygen is considered to be double bond only. So that's why oxygen's oxidation number is taken as minus 2. Then automatically carbon's oxidation number becomes plus 2. Even by keeping X also, we got it here as plus 2 only. Okay, so please write this as a note point. Note here, oxygen can act as a donor. Oxygen, the more electronegative element, En, I am writing in short, more En element acts as a donor here, acts as a donor, and there forms what? There forms a coordinate covalent bond. Okay, coordinate covalent bond will form. Okay, but that coordinate covalent bond is not considered as a single bond here. We are just treating it as a double bond in between carbon and oxygen. That's why oxidation numbers of carbon and oxygen are treated as what? Plus 2 and minus 2 only respectively. Okay, so this is about carbon monoxide, the first example for the compounds in which carbon is having plus 2 oxidation state. Okay, then we go for second example, CO2. Oxygen minus 2, carbon x. So 1 into x plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0. X equal to plus 4. Okay, even if you take the structure, carbon dioxide structure, how does it will be? There will be a double bond in between carbon and both the oxygens. So here minus 2, plus 2. And here also in between first and second carbon, plus 2, minus 2. So total carbon's oxidation number, total it is equal to plus 4 only. According to the structure also, you are getting plus 4 only. Okay, so oxidation number of carbon in carbon dioxide is how much? Plus 4. Okay, you can take the third example, COCl2. This side I am rubbing. COCl2. What is that? Phosgene. Okay, like this, we'll see some examples. Phosgene. Example 3, COCl2. What is this? Phosgene. Okay, phosgene. In this, chlorine's oxidation number minus 1. Oxygen's is minus 2. Carbon's, if you keep it as X. So, 1 into X plus 1 into minus 2 plus 2 into minus 1 is equal to 0. So, X minus 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0 and X equal to 4. Okay, so in phosgene, oxidation number of carbon is equal to how much? Plus 4. Phosgene, COCl2. If you go for the structure, okay, then also you'll be getting plus 4 only. Okay, COCl2. So, in between C and O, you are finding double bond and ClCl. Okay, oxygen minus 2, carbon plus 2. Chlorine minus 1, carbon plus 1. Chlorine minus 1, carbon plus 1. Here also, if you just check the carbon's oxidation number, plus 2, plus 1, plus 1, which is equal to what? Plus 4. Therefore, oxidation number of carbon in COCl2 is equal to how much? Plus 4. Okay. So, next move on to the next example. Methane, you know. Methane, CH4. Okay. Simple compound, CH4. Okay, methane. Hydrogens plus 1. So, carbons will be minus 4 it will become. Isn't it? Let us check. Okay, CH4. Example 4. CH4. That is what? Methane. Okay. Hydrogen plus 1. Carbon CX you will keep. Okay. So, 1 into X plus 4 into plus 1 is equal to 0. X plus 4 is equal to 0. X equal to minus 4. Even if you check for the structure. CH4. Okay. So, hydrogens plus 1, carbon minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, here also plus 1, minus 1. So, 4 hydrogens, okay, plus 1 and the center carbon will have minus 1. Carbon being more electronegative than hydrogen, it is considered to be the negative, okay. So, minus 4, okay. So, carbon's oxidation number, even with the structure, we got what? Minus 4. Okay, so like this. Okay, next we'll move on to the example 5. What is that? Methyl chloride, CH3Cl. Okay, right? CH3Cl. Methyl chloride. Okay, here chlorine's oxidation number is minus 1, hydrogen plus 1, carbon we don't know, let us keep it as X. So, 1 into X plus 3 into plus 1 plus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, chlorine's is minus 1, that you know, hydrogen's is plus 1, right? Carbon's you are keeping it as X, so X plus 3 minus 1 is equal to 0, X plus 2 is equal to 0 and X equal to minus 2. We'll check with the structure. CH3Cl. Okay, 3 hydrogens and 1 chlorine. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. But here chlorine minus 1, carbon plus 1. Okay, so here what you will be getting total if you see? Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus 1. Plus 1, minus 1 gets cancelled. So, what are left with? Minus 2 only. Okay, here also you got minus 2. And by checking the structure, that also you got minus 2 only. Okay, so CH3Cl, methyl chloride is what? Minus 2 oxidation number. Okay, so here ON of carbon is how much? Minus 4. And here ON of carbon is equal to minus 2. Right? We'll see the next example. Okay, next, chloroform. Example 6 is what? Chloroform, CHCl3. Okay, chlorine minus 1, hydrogen plus 1, carbon X. So 1 into X plus 1 into plus 1 plus 3 into minus 1 is equal to 0. So X plus 1 minus 3 is equal to 0. X minus 2 is equal to 0 and X equal to 2. So CHCl3, if you go for the structure, okay, 1 hydrogen and 3 chlorines. Okay, hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Chlorine minus 1, carbon plus 1. Chlorine being more electronegative, it will have minus 1. Okay, it is more electronegative than carbon. So carbon will have plus 1 and chlorine will have minus 1. So chlorine minus 1, carbon plus 1. Check with the center. Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1. Okay, so here also you got how much? Plus 2 only. Okay. So, CHCl3 is what? Chloroform. Okay, chloroform. Okay, oxidation number of carbon, ON of carbon is equal to plus 2. Okay, for chloroform. Right? Next, we go for the next example, CCl4. Okay, same like CH4. CCl4. What is CCl4? Carbon tetrachloride. Okay, now carbon tetrachloride. Example 7, CCl4. Chlorine minus 1, carbon X. So 1 into X plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so X minus 4 is equal to 0 and X equal to plus 4. If you check with the structure, okay, CCl4. CCl4 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 here also minus 1 plus 1. So if you check for the carbon's oxidation number in CCl4, it is found to be plus 4 only. Therefore ON of carbon in CCl4 is how much? Plus 4. Okay, next we'll move on to the next compound, that is C2H5OH. Okay, C2H5OH, methyl alcohol, ethyl alcohol, all these things. Okay, right, before that, same like CCl4, you have another compound which is called as freon. Okay, freon CF2Cl2. Eighth one, freon. Okay, freon is what? CF2Cl2. Same like the structure. Okay, here carbon's X, fluorine's is minus 1 and chlorine's is also minus 1. Okay, so 1 into X plus 2 into minus 1 plus 2 into minus 1 is equal to 0. X minus 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0 and X equal to plus 4. Okay, because both the fluorines, okay, both the fluorines as well as chlorines are what? CF2Cl2. Freon. Okay, so minus 1 plus 1, here also minus 1 plus 1, minus 1 plus 1, minus 1, okay, minus 1 plus 1. So carbon's oxidation number, if you check, you are getting plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to what? Plus 4. Therefore ON of carbon in freon is how much? Plus 4. ON of carbon in freon is how much? Plus 4. Even in CCl4 also, it is plus 4 only. Okay, so let us next move on to the examples of some organic compounds like methyl alcohol, ethyl alcohol, like that. Okay, let us see. Okay, question number 9. Suppose if you go for CH3OH, methyl alcohol. Okay, CH3OH. What is this? Methanol. Or methyl alcohol. Hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, carbon X. So 1 into X plus 3 into plus 1 plus 1 into minus 2 plus 1 into plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, you are following what? First rule for oxidation numbers. Okay, X plus 3 minus 2 plus 1 is equal to 0. So X, 3 minus 2 is 3 plus 1, 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is plus 2 is equal to 0. So x equal to minus 2. Okay. So for CH3OH, oxidation number of carbon is found to be how much? Minus 2. Okay. If you check with the structure, CH3OH. Okay. CH3OH. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. And in between C and O, O is more electronegative. So, minus 1 goes for O, oxygen. And for carbon, it will be plus 1 only. Okay. So, minus 3 plus 1. How much it is? Minus 3 plus 1, which is equal to minus 2. Therefore, ON of carbon. Okay. ON of C is equal to how much? Minus 2. Okay. So, CH3OH. Right. And next, same like that, even you can calculate for ethyl alcohol also. We'll go for acids. Okay. Acids. Okay. Example 10. Okay. So, let us check. Okay. HCOOH. What is this? Formic acid. HCOOH. Which is called as what? Formic acid. Okay, so C double bond O, O, H, and this side also H. Okay, so you want carbon's oxidation number. Hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Oxygen minus 2, carbon plus 2. Okay, in between C and O, carbon plus 1, oxygen minus 1. Okay, if you just check, you are finding carbon's oxidation number to be plus 3. Sorry, 2 plus 1, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2 only. Okay, let us check X method. Okay, HCOOH. Hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2, oxygen minus 2, carbon X, hydrogen plus 1. So 1 into 1 plus 1 into X plus 2 into minus 2 plus 1 into 1 is equal to 0. So 1 plus X minus 4 plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. 1 plus 1 is 2, x as it is written, 2 minus 4 is minus 2, is equal to 0. So, x equal to minus 2, sorry, plus 2. Therefore, oxidation number of carbon in HCOOH is how much? Plus 2. Okay, check with the structure as well as with what we call first rule, oxidation number rule 1. Okay, right. And next, next we'll go for next example, example 11. Okay, if you go for example 11, glucose. Okay, C6H12O6. Okay, oxygen minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, carbon X. So 6 into X plus 12 into plus 1 plus 6 into minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, so 6x plus 12 minus 12 is equal to 0. Plus 12 minus 12 gets cancelled. You will get 6x is equal to 0. So, x equal to 0. Therefore, oxidation number of carbon in glucose is what? In glucose, you will find it to be equal to 0. Okay, so please remember. Glucose, oxidation number of carbon in glucose. Okay. Even you will get 0 even for sucrose also. What is sucrose? Or cane sugar. Okay, if you take it for cane sugar. Okay, cane sugar is what? Cane sugar. C12H22O11. Okay, carbon minus 2, oxygen minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, carbon X. So, 12 into X plus 22 into plus 1 plus 11 into minus 2 is equal to 0. So, 12x plus 22 minus 22 is equal to 0. Plus 22 minus 22 gets cancelled. So, 12x is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 0. Therefore, oxidation number of carbon in sugar is 0. Okay. So, you'll be getting oxidation number for carbon to be equal to what? 0. Okay, if you take CS2, example 13, CS2 here, CS2 is almost like carbon dioxide only. Okay, sulfur in the middle, both carbons, both sides bonded with double bond. Okay, so carbon plus 2, sulfur minus 2. Here also, carbon plus 2, sulfur minus 2. Okay, double bond. So sulfur's oxidation number is minus 4. Okay, so carbon X, sulfur, each sulfur's oxidation number minus 2 if you keep. So 1 into X plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0. Okay. What I have done? CS2. C in the middle, sulfurs. Okay. Sulfurs on both sides. Okay. Sulfur minus 2, sulfur minus 2. Carbon plus 2, carbon plus 2. Okay. CS2. So X equal to what? Plus 4. Okay. Here also carbon's oxidation number found to be plus 4. Therefore, ON of carbon in CS2 is how much? Plus 4. Oxidation number of carbon in CS2, carbon disulfide, is how much? Plus 4. Then we'll move on to the last two examples, okay, which are considered to be the most important. Okay, that is HCN, hydrogen cyanide. Okay, so 14th one, HC triple bond N. Okay, this is a general structure for HCN. Okay, here hydrogen plus 1, carbon minus 1. Okay, there is a triple bond between carbon and nitrogen. So carbon plus 3 and nitrogen minus 3, because nitrogen is more electronegative than carbon. Okay, so now carbon's oxidation number will be how much? Minus 3 plus 1, which is equal to 3 minus 1 is plus 2 only. Okay, if you keep X also, like HC triple bond N, if you keep X, hydrogen plus 1, nitrogen minus 3. Okay, so 1 into 1 plus 1 into X plus 1 into minus 3 is equal to 0. 1 plus X minus 3 is equal to 0. X minus 2 is equal to 0. X equal to 2. Okay, so ON of carbon in HCN is how much? Plus 2. Okay, if you take isocyanide, okay, hydrogen isocyanide, okay, the last and best example is what? Hydrogen isocyanide means what? HNC. Okay, HNC. Okay, you know that carbon is having valence electrons 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. By sharing with nitrogen's electrons, still it is not getting octet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. But nitrogen is having one lone pair. Okay, so nitrogen already having octet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8. Octet is there with nitrogen. So nitrogen can share or donate, means nitrogen can act as a donor. Okay, so here nitrogen, okay, forms a coordinate covalent bond with what? Carbon. Okay, but that coordinate covalent bond is not considered neglected here, because more electronegative element is acting as what? Donor. Please remember, wherever more electronegative element is acting as donor, then that coordinate covalent bond is not treated as a single bond. Okay, please try to understand that point. So hydrogen plus 1, nitrogen minus 1. And here nitrogen and carbon double bond is there. So minus 2, plus 2. Okay, so therefore carbon's oxidation number is how much? Plus 2 only. ON of carbon is equal to plus 2. Okay, so based on the structure, you will be getting for isocyanide, what is this? Hydrogen isocyanide. Okay, hydrogen isocyanide. So or oxidation number of carbon in HCN as well as HNC. Okay, in both the structures you will be getting plus 2 and plus 2 only, carbon's oxidation number. Okay, so this is all about different structures in which oxidation number of carbon ranges from minus 4 to plus 4. Okay, so thanks for watching, dear children. Those who are watching my videos for the first time, please kindly visit my channel, watch all the videos. Okay, and definitely you will feel that you must subscribe to this channel to get the best study videos from Lalita ma'am. Okay, thanks for watching, dear children. Okay, once again, without Doraemon's gadget, please, okay, fulfill my wish by subscribing to my channel. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.